Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I am going to talk about the endocrine system. So what should you know about the endocrine system? Regarding the formation of the endocrine system, it is formed of the endocrine glands and the hormones they secrete. So the endocrine system is made up of the endocrine glands and the hormones they secrete. What is the principal endocrine center? The principal endocrine center is the hypothalamus. And what is the master endocrine gland? The master endocrine gland is the pituitary gland. The endocrine glands are called ductless glands. They don't have ducts, and the hormones are released directly into the bloodstream. We cannot live without hormones. The hormones regulate our metabolism, our growth, development, mood, and the sexual function, male and female sexual function. Okay? So what are the endocrine glands? What is the master endocrine gland? The master endocrine gland is the pituitary gland. What are the other glands? Okay, thyroid gland, parathyroid glands, adrenal glands. We have two. Pancreas, islets of Langerhans, ovary, testis in the male, pineal gland in the brain, and the thymus gland. So these are the pituitary, the endocrine glands. Besides these endocrine glands, there are other endocrine cells present in different organs. Okay, so we'll start by the principal endocrine center, which is the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus controls the adenohypophysis and the neurohypophysis. Adenohypophysis is the anterior pituitary. Neurohypophysis is the posterior pituitary. So it controls, how it controls the adenohypophysis? By secreting 6 releasing hormones and 2 inhibiting hormones. The 6 releasing hormones are growth hormone releasing hormone, prolactin releasing hormone, thyrotropin releasing hormone, corticotropin releasing hormone, follicle stimulating hormone releasing hormone, and the luteinizing hormone releasing hormone. Okay? And the 2 inhibiting hormones are the growth hormone inhibiting hormone and the prolactin inhibiting hormone. So we have 2 hormones which have releasing and inhibiting hormones, growth hormone and the prolactin hormone. How about the neurohypophysis? How the hypothalamus controls the neurohypophysis? The hypothalamus secretes 2 hormones. The 2 hormones are antidiuretic hormone, it is also called the vasopressin, and the oxytocin. Regarding the pituitary gland, where is the pituitary gland? And what are the 2 divisions of the pituitary gland? The pituitary gland is located in the cranial cavity. This is the cranial cavity. It is located in the hypophyseal fossa. This hypophyseal fossa is present in the sphenoid bone. This is the sphenoid bone, and this is the sphenoid ear sinus. So the pituitary gland is present in the cranial cavity, is present in the hypophyseal fossa, and the hypophyseal fossa is present in the sphenoid bone. This pituitary gland is divided into 2 parts, 2 divisions, anterior pituitary and the posterior pituitary. Anterior pituitary is the adenohypophysis. Posterior pituitary is the neurohypophysis. Anterior pituitary secretes 7 hormones. Posterior pituitary secretes 2 hormones. So what are these hormones? The 7 anterior pituitary hormones are growth hormone. This growth hormone stimulates growth of bones and muscles, and also stimulates protein synthesis. So from the name, growth hormone stimulates bone growth and muscle growth. Second one, ACTH. ACTH, adrenocorticotropin. Adrenocorticotropin stimulates the adrenal cortex to produce corticosteroids, and the corticosteroids are aldosterone and cortisol. So ACTH stimulates the adrenal cortex, not the medulla, okay, to produce corticosteroids. Regarding thyroid stimulating hormone, TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone from the name stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete thyroid hormone, thyroxine. FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone stimulates the growth of the ovarian follicles and the production of estrogen. And in the male, it stimulates the sperm formation, sperm production. So follicle stimulating hormone in the female, it stimulates the growth of ovarian follicles and the production of estrogen, and in the male, it stimulates sperm formation. Luteinizing hormone, from the name luteinizing, corpus luteum, so luteinizing hormone stimulates ovulation and the formation of corpus luteum and the secretion of progesterone. Prolactin. Prolactin stimulates the mammary gland in the breast to produce milk. And the last one is melanocyte stimulating hormone, MSH. MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, it regulates skin pigmentation by melanocytes, and it may increase mental alertness. So what are the 7 hormones secreted by the anterior pituitary? Growth hormone, ACTH, thyroid stimulating hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, prolactin, and melanocyte stimulating hormone. What are the 2 hormones secreted by the posterior pituitary? What are the 2 hormones secreted by the neurohypophysis? They are actually secreted by the hypothalamus, the paraventricular nucleus, and the supraoptic nucleus. So the 2 hormones, antidiuretic hormone, from the name, antidiuretic. It prevents diuresis. It stimulates reabsorption of water by the kidney. It is also called vasopressin, because it causes vasoconstriction and it raises blood pressure. The second one is oxytocin. Oxytocin acts on 2 organs, acts on the uterus and acts on the mammary gland. Oxytocin stimulates contraction of the uterus during labor and stimulates contraction of the myoepithelial cells of the breast for milk ejection during lactation. So the 2 hormones secreted by the posterior pituitary, antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin. Antidiuretic hormone is also called vasopressin, and it stimulates reabsorption of water by the kidney. Oxytocin stimulates contraction of the uterus, okay, during labor, and this stimulates milk ejection during lactation. Regarding the thyroid gland, this is the thyroid gland. Where is the thyroid gland and what are the types of cells in the thyroid gland? Thyroid gland is located in front of the lower part of the neck. So this is the first location, in front of the lower part of the neck. Regarding the trachea, it is located in front, it surrounds the front and the sides of the trachea. So where is the thyroid gland? Thyroid gland is located in front of the lower part of the neck. It surrounds the front and the sides of the trachea. The thyroid gland contains two types of cells. The two types of cells are follicular cells and the parafollicular cells. These are the follicular cells, and the blue ones are the parafollicular cells. Parafollicular cells are called C cells because they secrete calcitonin. Okay? So what are the two hormones produced by the thyroid gland, and what are the functions of these hormones? The two hormones are, remember, two types of cells, follicular cells and parafollicular cells. Follicular cells secrete thyroid hormone, and thyroid hormone T3 and T4. T4 is called thyroxine. These hormones are secreted by the follicular cells. What is the difference between T3 and T4? T3 has three iodine molecules. T4 has four iodine molecules. Which one is thyroxine? Thyroxine is T4. So the first hormone secreted by the thyroid gland is the thyroid hormone, secreted by which cells? By the follicular cells. T3 has three iodine molecules, and the T4 has four iodine molecules. How about the parafollicular cells? Parafollicular cells, or C cells, secrete calcitonin. So what are the functions of these hormones? Regarding the thyroid hormone, thyroxine, it increases the basal metabolic rate and influences physical and mental development. It is very important for our physical and mental development. Hypersecretion and hyposecretion. Hypersecretion of T3 and T4 causes goiter and Graves' disease. Hyposecretion causes cretinism and myxedema. How about calcitonin? Calcitonin, it lowers the blood calcium. How it lowers the blood calcium? By increasing calcium secretion by the kidney. When? It occurs when calcium level in the blood is elevated. So what is the function of calcitonin? Calcitonin lowers the blood calcium. How? By increasing calcium secretion by the kidney. When the blood calcium level is elevated. So these are the functions of the hormones secreted by the thyroid gland. How about the parathyroid glands? How many parathyroid glands and where they are? The parathyroid glands are four. Two on each side. Where are they? The parathyroid glands are located along the posterior border of the thyroid gland. So parathyroid glands are four, and they are located along the posterior border of the thyroid gland. Two on each side. What are the types of cells in the parathyroid gland? Very similar to the thyroid, two cells. The two cells are chief cells and oxyphil cells. Chief cells secrete parathormone, and the parathormone is the parathyroid hormone. How about oxyphil cells? What is the function of oxyphil cells? Unknown function. So what are the types of cells secreted or present in the parathyroid gland? Chief cells and oxyphil cells. Which one of these cells is essential for life? The one which is essential for life is the chief cell. Why? Because the chief cell secretes parathormone or parathyroid hormone. So what are the functions of the parathormone? Parathormone is the parathyroid hormone. The function of the parathormone is opposite to the function of calcitonin. So parathormone increases blood calcium concentration. When blood calcium level is getting too low, how? Three mechanisms. The first one, it stimulates osteoclast to release more calcium from the bone. Second one, it decreases secretion of calcium by the kidney, unlike calcitonin. And the third one, activates vitamin D to stimulate uptake of calcium from the intestine. So what are the functions of the parathormone and what is the mechanism of action? The function of the parathormone is opposite to the function of calcitonin. Parathormone increases blood calcium concentration. How it increases blood calcium concentration? Three mechanisms. Number one, it stimulates osteoclasts to release more calcium from bone. Second one, decreases calcium secretion by the kidney. And third one, activation of vitamin D to stimulate uptake of calcium from the intestine. Regarding the pancreas, this is the pancreas. The pancreas is divided into two parts, exocrine part and the endocrine part. The exocrine part is made up of SNI, pancreatic SNI, which secrete pancreatic enzymes or pancreatic juice. The endocrine part is islets of Langerhans. So islets of Langerhans. What are the types of cells in islets of Langerhans? Three types of cells. First one, alpha cells. Alpha cells secrete glucagon. Glucagon, it raises blood sugar. Second one, beta cells. And beta cells are many, are more numerous. The more numerous cells are the beta cells. Beta cells secrete insulin, and the insulin, it lowers blood sugar. And the third one, delta cells. Delta cells are few, and they secrete somatostatin, and the somatostatin inhibits glucagon. So it is similar to insulin. So what are the three types of cells in islets of Langerhans? Alpha, beta, and the delta cells. Alpha cells, okay, present along the periphery of the islets of Langerhans, and they secrete glucagon. Beta cells are many, and they secrete insulin. Delta cells are few, and they secrete somatostatin. And somatostatin inhibits glucagon. Then the adrenal gland. This is the adrenal gland. Where is it? And what are the divisions of the adrenal gland? The adrenal gland is located on the top of the kidney. That's why it has another name. It's called the suprarenal gland. So why it is called the suprarenal gland? It's called the suprarenal gland because it is located above the kidney. It is divided into two parts. The outer part is the cortex, and the inner part is the medulla. So adrenal gland is located on the top of the kidney. It is divided into cortex and the medulla. The cortex is the outer part, the medulla is the inner part. What are the hormones secreted by the adrenal gland? Remember, cortex and the medulla. So from the cortex, corticosteroids. Cortex, cortico, okay? Corticosteroids. From the medulla, catecholamines. Corticosteroids are two. Aldosterone and cortisol. Aldosterone stimulates reabsorption of sodium by the kidney. And cortisol is essential for life. This cortisol helps the body to deal with stress. Regarding the medulla, catecholamines, epinephrine or adrenaline. Epinephrine prepares the body for defense. Remember, 3F, fight, flight, and fear. Okay? They stimulate the secretion of epinephrine, adrenaline. The second one is norepinephrine or noradrenaline, the same action. So what are the hormones secreted by the adrenal gland? From the cortex, corticosteroids. From the medulla, catecholamines. What are the corticosteroids? Aldosterone and cortisol. Aldosterone stimulates reabsorption of sodium by the kidney, and the cortisol is essential for life. It helps the body to deal with stress. From the medulla, catecholamines, epinephrine, and norepinephrine. Epinephrine is adrenaline, norepinephrine is noradrenaline. Okay? They prepare the body for defense. Regarding the pineal gland, this is the pineal gland. It is part of the brain. Where is it? And which hormone is secreted by the pineal gland? So, location. It is part of the diencephalon. This is the diencephalon. It is part of the diencephalon. Or actually, it is part of the epithalamus, which is part of the diencephalon. It is located above the midbrain. This is the midbrain. This is the tectum of the midbrain. So pineal gland is part of the diencephalon. It is part of the epithalamus. It is located above the midbrain. It secretes melatonin. So pineal gland secretes melatonin in response to darkness. That's why melatonin is called the hormone of darkness. So the secretion is stimulated by darkness and is inhibited by light. So melatonin, it has effect on the sleep awake cycles, and it is antioxidant. So pineal gland is part of the diencephalon, is part of the epithalamus. It is located above the midbrain. Okay, it secretes melatonin in response to darkness, and the melatonin is called hormone of darkness. Okay, then ovarian hormones and testicular hormones. Ovarian hormones are two, estrogen and the progesterone. Estrogen is secreted by the ovarian follicles, and the progesterone is secreted by corpus luteum. Actually, estrogen is secreted mainly by the ovarian follicles, and few, okay, less amount is secreted by the corpus luteum. What is the function of each one? Estrogen is essential for the growth, development, and the maintenance of the female sex organs. Progesterone, it prepares the uterus for pregnancy. So the two hormones secreted by the ovary, estrogen and the progesterone. Estrogen is secreted mainly by ovarian follicles. Progesterone is secreted by corpus luteum. Progesterone is very important during the pregnancy, okay? And it also prepares the uterus for pregnancy. How about the testis? It secretes only one hormone, testosterone. Testosterone is secreted by Leydig cells. It is similar to estrogen, but in the male, okay? It is essential for growth, development, and the maintenance of the male sex organs. And finally, what are the other endocrine cells? Other endocrine cells present in other organs. There are many, so I will select some of them. Okay, the pylorus of the stomach. secretes the hormone gastrin, and gastrin is important for HCL production. How about the duodenum and the jejunum? The duodenum and the jejunum secrete the hormone secretin, and secretin is essential for stimulating the pancreatic and the bile secretion. How about the thymus gland? Thymus gland secretes the hormone thymosin. What is the function of thymosin? Thymosin stimulates the production of T lymphocytes. How about the placenta? Placenta secretes many hormones like estrogen, progesterone, human chorionic gonadotropin, human placental lactogen, melanin splitting factors. Okay? How about the kidney? The kidney, the juxtaglomerular cells secrete renin. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.